For more than 60 years, Germans have traveled by plane on their holidays. From the very beginning, Condor has had a significant part of this evolution, which made it to one of the most important leisure airlines in the world. They have always managed through their pioneering spirit, innovations, quality and service to successfully navigate the world's complex aviation industry.
Hello.
Do you love traveling too? Discovering foreign countries and cultures by car? That's so yesterday. Today, you need to fly. May I invite you to travel through time into the history of Condor, a journey that begins in 1956 and follows the path of one of the most historic and the first airline in Germany with more than 6 decades in aviation heritage. We start with our maiden flight to the Holy Land and to Egypt. We, that is the airline Deutsche Flugdienst GmbH, and our first headquarter is located in the middle of Frankfurt, in the Weißfrauenstraße number 3, on the first floor. At that time we had a royal blue uniform, featuring a jacket with 50 buttons from top to bottom. In addition, we wore a little hat and white gloves while welcoming the passengers. The flight service was conducted in a hangar at the airport where Terminal 2 was later built. By 1958, 2 years later, the management together with the flight service moved into wooden barracks in the northeast of Frankfurt Airport. After long negotiations with the Allied nations, the Federal Republic of Germany was declared to be a sovereign nation again on the 5th of May 1955 and therefore regained its air sovereignty. By December of that year, Deutsche Lufthansa, HAPAG with the North German Lloyd and the German Federal Railway formed the new company Deutsche Flugdienst GmbH. On the 29th of March 1956 it was time. With 3 Vickers Viking aircraft, a party of tourists started from Frankfurt with 2 stops in Nice and Athens to Beirut and then on to Jerusalem the next morning. The Vickers Viking was very reliable. It was an old Wellington bomber still complete with a set of stairs. Most of the stewardesses had bruised knees because they leaned on the stairs and waited until it became quieter at altitude before starting service. After several days of stopover, featuring a tour through the city, the party flew to Egypt and then via Athens and Nice again on their way back home. This flight was considered to be the beginning of one of the first German charter airlines, later named Condor. The journey was organized by the German tour operator Hans Geisler. Our father, Hans Geisler, in 1956 had the idea to charter a plane from Condor because he had American customers, such as US Army employees like nurses, doctors or teachers who were stationed in Frankfurt. In their spare time they just sat around and had no chance to get back to America, so they had to be entertained. And he had the idea to charter a plane and bring them to Jerusalem and Bethlehem. This was the first destination he ever planned. I have to admit that it was a different kind of traveling. The Americans were very elegant and this was an experience. And also the first stop to the Holy Land was in Pisa. Today you simply could not do that. It was a completely different kind of traveling. The people dressed well. The men wore ties and the ladies wore nice suits and acted very elegantly. But do you know where you can also spend really nice holidays? Sure, in Mallorca. The ones who prefer a more exotic destination can fly on our modern propeller aircraft Convair to Tenerife. Our new slogan, Condor, your holiday charter, says it all.
Ist dabei Programm.
Für Pudding und Cremespeisen.
For puddings and creams, we simply use Dr. Oetker. But what has pudding got to do with aviation? On the 26th of February 1957, Rudolf August Oetker founded the Condor Luftreederei GmbH in Hamburg. Oetker was at this time already the largest seafaring ship owner in the Federal Republic of Germany. His move to invest in a German aircraft fleet was an obvious one to him. He bought 2 Convair Metropolitan aircraft, one of the most modern and comfortable commercial aircraft at this time. The Convair was significantly more comfortable and quieter, and all passengers wanted to fly on it. After its initial success, the market and booking figures collapsed in 1959. He then got an offer from Lufthansa in March 1961 to sell Condor Luftreederei GmbH. He did not hesitate. At the end of the year, the new charter flight daughter of Lufthansa was named Condor Flugdienst GmbH. But how could the newly founded airline survive in this market at all? The industry has previously experienced some trouble with bankruptcies and accidents. This was because two airlines have gone bankrupt and left their guests on their own and had to wait for days until flying back home. There were no travel back insurances, no credit cards to book your own tickets. People really were stuck on the Canary Islands. In the end, the guests had to write a help telegram to the federal government in order to get rescued. We really had to try to regain their trust. This damaged the reputation of the charter flight industry to such an extent that nobody even wanted to book anymore, even from the reputable companies. That's why we had to work from the inside and also from the outside. It was important to build confidence inside the company in order to say, we are somebody. At the same time, we had to show that we had modern aircraft, were punctual and had a good service. This paid off. After the massive decline in 1959, there was a phenomenal boom, and Condor used this to its advantage. 1965 was a special year for Condor, because the first jet aircraft was introduced. This was something completely new in tourism, and with the 727, it was not just any airplane, but at that time, it was the most powerful aircraft in this size category. We fly on our new comfortable and faster jets towards the sun. Condor now flies long haul. Thailand, Sri Lanka, Kenya or the Dominican Republic are our new holiday destinations far away. On long-haul flights, there was no entertainment as we know it today. We often had to do our own show on board. One colleague often brought his guitar and played on it. The captain organized a quiz, and the winner was allowed to sit in the cockpit while landing. Today, this would not be possible. With our new Boeing 727, we are now able to welcome up to 127 guests on board. The headquarters got bigger as well. In September 1970, the management was able to leave its barracks at the airport and move to a contemporary new building in Gravenbruch. But after 3 years, this building was again too small and a new building in the Hans-Böckler-Straße in Neu-Isenburg became the new home of Condor. In 1963, a long-time partnership began with another pioneer in the history of tourism. Josef Neckermann, with his Frankfurt-based company NUR Touristik, offered flights for package holidays. A dream holiday to the Orient with Neckermann and Condor, the daughter company of Lufthansa. Fly, experience, recover. Neckermann makes it possible. As prosperity increased, so did the Wanderlust, and in 1970, Condor celebrated its 500,000th passenger. The market grew enormously and we needed bigger aircraft. The Boeing 747 was suggested, which was a huge move. The introduction of the Boeing 747 was a highlight in the life of Condor. You have to imagine, Lufthansa only got its 747 1 year before any competitor. There were no charter airlines in the world with a 747. A smaller aircraft like the DC-10 or TriStar were much cheaper, but we had to have this aircraft. Together with Lufthansa, we looked at which options were left on their option list. Lufthansa had advanced bookings. One aircraft was pre-booked for 1971, and then we committed and said, we will do this. We concluded contracts with operators, had all our preparations running on this date until it became clear that it was a typo. The secretary had written down the wrong year. We then negotiated with the representatives of Boeing in a restaurant close to the airport until 4 a.m. when Seattle opened. In principle, Boeing agreed with us if there were no big alterations planned concerning the aircraft. We were able to get the aircraft, and since then, we have just ordered our aircraft in annual periods. And as was typical for the director Wendlich, he later brought the secretary a bouquet of flowers for her typo. During the ferry flight from Seattle to Hamburg, I initially wanted to organize a bicycle race. Only journalists were invited, and we wanted to organize a bicycle race in the empty aircraft. But the bikes were stolen, and so we had a table tennis game with all the journalists on board instead, between Condor and the journalists. Of course, we won. And this was the first table tennis game at an altitude of 10,000 meters. It was a Guinness World Record. Nobody ever played at that altitude. As the first charter airline in the world, Condor used two Jumbo 747s since 1971, which were named Fritz and Max. Lufthansa named their aircraft after the 9 federal states at that time. With our kind of naming, we had unlimited options. Max and Fritz were just the results of a whimsical thought. Initially, Moritz was supposed to join, but the third aircraft was only leased and therefore would not be around forever. But everybody in Germany said, Max and Fritz. This was a real sensation. Because of their length, some factory halls even had to be extended. On the maiden flight of our Boeing 747 to Mallorca, a lot is going on. And on this day, when the aircraft was standing at the Frankfurt airport, it was unbelievable. The introduction of the Jumbos was phenomenal. Everybody wanted to fly with this huge plane, and we were supposed to fly to airports who had never seen aircraft this big. Mallorca, for example, or Ibiza, or Las Palmas and Colombo. In Ceylon, today it's called Sri Lanka, there were elephants on the apron. They said hello to their big brother. And these were great experiences for passengers and crew. When the Jumbo was introduced in 1972 with 492 passengers, the dispatch was difficult. The biggest challenge was that the equipment on the airports was missing. It was very difficult at small airports, for example in Mallorca, where suddenly two Jumbos with a total of 1,000 passengers landed. One has simply put a hole in the fence, and the passengers walk through the hole directly to the buses, which are waiting to bring them to their individual destinations.
Die dann schon bereit standen und sie zu den einzelnen Zielorten fuhren.
Es gab auch keine Platzkarten, das war ja auch so eine
There were also no seat reservations. It was always funny when the people walked from the check-in hall to the aircraft. In the beginning they all walked slowly behind the ground hostess and on the subsequent 50 to 100 meters the passengers then started running. The first one on board usually got a bottle of sparkling wine or a banana.
Das Unternehmen Triumph präsentiert.
The company called Triumph presented on the 1st of May 1971 its new swimwear collection while flying. At times, the upper deck of the Jumbo was transformed into a hair salon and the hairstyle local turbulence is created. Although the Jumbo particularly stood in the public eye because of its size, the smaller Boeing 727 machines were the backbone of the Condor fleet. The 727 was truly a special aircraft, one where pilots still get teary-eyed. Overall, the Boeing 727 in its various constellations was then in use for Condor for almost 25 years. You really can't expect more from an aircraft. For the two giant Jumbos, it was soon to be a goodbye. In 1979, it was decided with a heavy heart to sell the two Boeing 747s, Fritz and Max.
Der Jumbo. Ich muss das mal sagen, der hat eigentlich
The jumbo, I have to say, was not taken out of service because it failed, but because of its size. That's how we got the idea of selling two 747s and buying three DC-10s. For the staff, mostly for the pilots, this was a shock. These beautiful 747 aircraft to trade with DC-10s, but the decision was definitely the right one and paid off. In the following years, three McDonnell Douglas DC-10 machines were bought. These were supplied with a polished fuselage. Since the paint on a plane is a large contributing factor to an aircraft's weight, a lot of fuel could be saved. This played a major economic role after the experiences of two major oil crises in 1973 and 1979. An important highlight on board our new airplane. We now have the newest video technology on board, the so-called VHS cassettes. From now on, we only have to press one button and it starts. On your flight, you can now watch blockbusters and documentaries on your destinations and your flight passes in no time. In the beginning of the 80s, the German tourism industry had a big crisis. The oil price increased by 30% and the additional costs of kerosene were only able to be compensated by a fuel surcharge for the customers. This led to a large wave of cancellations at the tour operators. A remarkable number of tourists were shocked by the big price increases for air travel packages. At the end of 1979, the second oil crisis occurred. This created two problems for Condor. Not only had the oil price increased by half during the previous year, which is bad enough for an airline already, but in 1979, the drop in the market was even bigger than in 1973. We had to fight in order to survive. To make matters even worse, tourists were confused and no longer knew whether they could even afford a vacation trip and then decided as a precaution measure, let's rather travel by car. In the beginning of the 80s, after the crisis had been overcome, there were suddenly new airlines on the market who flew for ridiculously low prices and fought their way into the market. The result was Condor reported a loss for the first time since 1960. The oil crisis in the beginning of the 80s had a dramatic effect on the travel sector. The bookings broke down. We as the crew suddenly had 20 days off in 1 month instead of 10 days. Suddenly it was about who might be leaving first. But thankfully, it did not get any worse than that, and the crisis was overcome. The recovery from the oil crisis was not that easy for Condor, because Lufthansa came to the conclusion that they might no longer need the company. Despite the difficulties, Dr. Kullmann held his helping hand over Condor and expected that there might be some years with a loss, but he realized the importance of Condor. Dr. Kullmann was the best chairman of the board you could ever wish for. Great expertise, and from the first moment he understood what Condor had to offer to Lufthansa. In 1983, the increase in bookings finally occurred, and since then we have developed new booking channels and developed new customer tiers. It was more essential that all staff members helped to overcome the crisis. That's why we made 100 million in profit in 1986. We fly to new destinations again, for example to Toronto and Dallas, but also exotic ones such as Kathmandu in Nepal and Goa in India. As a leisure airline, Condor was always able to act more cheekily than other airlines. This can especially be seen in its commercials.
Küssen Sie sich doch mal an Stellen, an denen Sie sich noch nie geküsst haben. Wir bringen Sie hin.
Condor, your leisure airline with 69 destinations.
Flieger mit 69 Zielen.
Our guests always wanted to travel more customized. That's why Condor offers flights to book themselves, and Condor Individual was born. In the beginning of the 90s, Condor bought 27 new Boeing 757 and 767s into their fleet. The special thing about the 757 was that in 1999, Condor was the launching customer of the model 757-300 and therefore was the first client worldwide to get this aircraft model. The Boeing 727 at this time was an old aircraft with a high fuel consumption and high noise levels. It was necessary to exchange the 727 with modern aircraft, and the 757 met the new noise levels and fuel consumption was essentially cheaper. The Boeing 757 and 767 complemented each other well, because the 767 could be flown with the same cockpit as the 757. The management of Condor had to pack their belongings again. The spacious new Condor headquarter could now be found in the Am Grünen Weg in Kelsterbach. The economic success of Condor was not only because of the reduction of cost structures and the increase in demand, but also because of its many innovations. For example, the introduction of the new Condor Comfort Class in 1991 was a success right away. The seating of the Condor aircraft, or generally speaking of all leisure airlines, was always very narrow, and the passengers craved for comfort. So when Condor introduced the Comfort Class, the passengers loved it. The offer was similar to business classes, but was offered for a significantly lower price, which was a great idea for the leisure airline.
Für einen Ferienflieger im Angebot.
Diese herrlichen Sitze bequem.
These superb seats were comfortable and the service was incredible. One could easily compare the Comfort Class with Lufthansa's business class. Especially the flights to the Maldives or to Mauritius were nearly always completely booked in the Comfort Class.
Die Dame, was darf ich Ihnen anbieten?
Hello, madam, what may I offer you? A dark bread or a pretzel roll? Here in the 1991 introduced Comfort Class, we pamper our guests with a high-quality service and a five-course menu all-inclusive. With this, you can fly relaxed to our new destinations, Aruba, Cuba or to Las Vegas.
Die Boeing 767 kam bei den Kunden sehr gut an.
The 767 was very popular with our customers, and sometimes there were standing ovations and shouts for encores. The captain sometimes agreed and flew 10 more minutes.
Der Kapitän kam dem einen oder anderen auch mal kurz nach, noch mal 10 Minuten extra Schleife zu fliegen.
What do you want for your birthday? Condor asked itself exactly this question for its 40th anniversary, and thereupon assigned the New York artist James Ritzy to create his own design.
Der Jubiläumsflieger zum 40. Jubiläum.
The anniversary aircraft for the 40th anniversary of Condor, on the one hand, had the idea to create a special plane, painted by artists and not simple and plain. Therefore, various artists were assigned to paint model aircraft.
Von der Größe, also noch größer zu bemalen, und gewonnen hat diese.
And James Ritzy won the selection process. At that time he was a popular pop art artist, and the aircraft was one of our cheeriest ones. All the others looked more sad, and it became an attraction on every airport. At the end of the 90s, smaller airports were included into the flight program. In order to work economically and flexibly, the subsidiary airline Condor Berlin was founded, with their headquarters in Berlin-Schönefeld.
Bei der Abwägung für die günstigste Variante.
The cheapest way for the company to operate flights with between 140 to 180 seats was to establish a subsidiary. That's how Condor Berlin at Schönefeld Airport was founded. In 1997, Condor merged with the tour operator Neckermann to the travel group CNN Touristik AG. But why would you connect an airline with a tour operator? The strategy for the founding of CNN Touristik saw Condor acquire Touristik München, Fischer Reisen in Hamburg und Air Marine in Düsseldorf in the early 90s. It is like in the English market where a carrier and operator merged, and the carrier transported the operator, while the operator booked all passengers to this carrier.
Und so gab es Gespräche mit Neckermann. Und
that's why there were conversations between Condor and Neckermann, which led to the Condor and Neckermann Touristik, CNN Touristik.
CNN Touristik.
But the acquisitions continued.
Ja, im Rahmen einer globalen.
During a global expansion strategy, there was the consideration to also include an English operator, and the CNN Touristik purchased Thomas Cook in England.
Den Veranstalter Thomas Cook in England. Herr Pichler, damals
Mr. Pichler, back then chairman of CNN Touristik and later Thomas Cook AG, had the idea that Thomas Cook would be a better name for the international market. Thomas Cook was unknown in Germany, and in order to increase the awareness level, there was the idea of repainting the Condor logo with the Thomas Cook logo. We did not rename the company, and the brand Thomas Cook was flown throughout the world. ...160 years of vacation experience? Germany's most popular leisure airline connects with the biggest name in the world of traveling. Condor becomes Thomas Cook. Thomas Cook. Enjoy every moment. In the course of renaming CNN Touristik to Thomas Cook AG, all aircrafts were supposed to carry the name of the European travel giant, One-Stop Holidays. This was the new principle of the integrated tourism company. Tour operator, airline and hotels combined in one company. This brought advantages and sounded an easy principle, but the practice was more difficult than anticipated. The familiar Condor logo was removed and replaced by the Thomas Cook logo. While mounting the new name, we did not want to lose the name Condor entirely. Through this, the idea was born to introduce Thomas Cook, powered by Condor. Especially to the staff, Condor was more than just a company name written on the tickets. The name stood for quality, a great holiday, safety and a quality service. As employees, you were confused because Condor was a strong brand and all of a sudden this strong brand disappeared from the market. We were not quite sure if customers would see it similarly. The customers had the feeling that the English tour operator bought Condor and that Condor did not exist anymore. It was difficult to explain to our customers. The decades-long tradition of the airline Condor, and with it the brand-related quality, should be replaced by the relatively unknown brand in Germany, Thomas Cook. This decision not only surprised customers, partners and staff, but also the public too. Furthermore, the passengers were not able to connect the new name Thomas Cook with the feeling and trust they were used to from Condor. Another third of all Condor flights were booked by other tour operators, who naturally like to see a more neutral name on the aircraft and not the name of another tour operator. We had bad business results the time between 2002 to 2004, which was the time after 9/11, when the entire global industry collapsed. Also, the tour operators and not just the airline Condor suffered very much back then. In 2003, Thomas Cook Condor made approximately €270 million of losses, and therefore it became clear. Condor needed to be revived. With the entrance of Mr. Tettentrup into the executive management of Condor, it was decided that the name Condor should be seen on the aircraft again, which was a great idea. To be honest, I have signed a contract with Condor, and my personal genes always were that Condor should be Condor and not Thomas Cook. When the name Condor finally came back, we as employees were delighted. The name Condor was painted back on the aircraft and the traditional name was back. When I came to Condor, I analyzed the company in a very detailed way during my first 3 months. I did not focus on what we had to improve in detail, but considered where most of all was a disorder. And I have to admit, in April 2004, I sat on my couch on a Sunday and asked myself, are we able to fix this problem within Condor, or is shutting down the only option for this company?
In
2004,
the turnaround started. After I have asked myself the question whether to close the company or not, I have talked to staff members as well as to representatives of all labor unions, to work councils of the staff committee, but also to all of Condor's 3,000 employees. I have explained where the company was at that time and what we all had to do, according to my opinion, in order to ensure that the mess got sorted out. In the end, all parties agreed on rejuvenating the company. Furthermore, there were detailed plans about what every department had to make on savings, which were pursued weekly or monthly. Mr. Teckentrop also had a very detailed schedule. In 2004, he came to Condor, created a very detailed program with measurements to improve the expense situation, as well as to increase the demand. In this period, the seat-only sales, for example, were increased severely. In the past years, the seat-only sales were located at the tour operators, but it came back to Condor and we had many possibilities to develop our seat-only business. The online presence was renewed and updated. Fliegenpreisaktionen were introduced, which were very successful in the market. Extra services were developed in the sections of special meals, seat reservations, and also cost range savings were achieved due to the introduction of ticketless traveling, for example. There were a range of measurements, and with regard to the seat-only sales, I just named a few, which led to Condor's recovery. Moreover, the identification of the customers with Condor was back again. In order to promote the new and attractive offers from Condor, in 2004 the airline was thinking about a completely new advertising campaign, and the Fly was born. She accompanied Condor for 11 years and attracted great attention. Condor's customers eagerly waited for the beloved Fliegenpreise as well as special offers in Condor's route network.
Früher oder später fliegen wir Sie zu den schönsten Urlaubszielen. Schon ab 49,99 Euro. Nur buchbar von Donnerstag bis Samstag. Die Condor Eintagsfliegen.
And again, there was another round birthday.
Unser 50. Geburtstag wurde mit einem tollen
Our 50th birthday was celebrated with a great gift to us and our guests. In honor of Wilfried Meyer, who worked 30 years for Condor's success, we simply named our heart aircraft Willy.
Einfach Willy.
For its 50th birthday, Condor had a special idea. It was an aircraft with big hearts named Willy, in honor of Wilfried Meyer, our longtime head of sales. Wilfried worked for more than 20 years for our company and worked significantly on Condor's evolution and on shaping the company. Since the recovery, Condor is the only German airline which is constantly profitable. But what measurements were necessary to achieve this? We fly with high productivity, with many seats in our aircraft, with a good cost structure and a high level of seat load factor to various regions in the world. Long haul is a very profitable part for us. We offer a great product with our business class, premium class, economy class, and we also offer a sensational price-performance ratio. You would have to search hard to find a business class or premium class close to this price on the market.
Eine Business Class oder eine Premium Class für den Preis überhaupt im Markt findet.
Extensive investments in products and fleet were done. 2.5 meter high winglets, which were copied from birds by the architects, were attached to the wings in order to save up to 5% kerosene per year and aircraft. And interiors were renewed as well, in order to make the flight even more comfortable for the passengers. Additionally, Condor, as the first leisure airline, introduced the premium economy class on long-haul flights, and shortly afterwards also on short and medium-haul flights. In 2008, Condor's technical services started operations for the first time in the south of Frankfurt Airport. Here, our Boeing fleet gets maintained in every detail. In 2009, Condor separated from its mother company Lufthansa after over 50 years and became a 100% subsidiary of the Thomas Cook AG in Oberursel. And our new headquarters was built right next to the airport in the new district Gateway Gardens. And in 2012, we finally moved in. Now we have come full circle back to our place of origin, our hangar from the early years, just a couple of hundred meters away from here. Besides the new headquarters, there is also a new corporate logo, which brands the entire Thomas Cook Group, including Condor and its three sisters. In 2013, Condor started working together with its siblings from Manchester, Brussels and Copenhagen. The technical services of all four airlines are united in the collective Group Maintenance Organization, short GMO. The group airlines were born, and the Thomas Cook Group finally reunited under the uniform symbol, the Sunny Heart. This can be seen from now on. Condor flies with heart. The Sunny Heart decorates the tail unit of the entire fleet, which has received a completely new look. The merger of Thomas Cook Airlines is something special in the airline sector. Condor only operates 45 aircraft, but together all airlines operate 95 aircraft, with more than 3.5 billion in revenue and more than 6,000 employees. Condor together with its sisters has a great size, which creates advantages. The merger of the Thomas Cook Airlines was a logical step forward. Why not use the synergy effects that are generated? Equal processes, equal manuals, maybe even an exchange of aircraft when they are needed somewhere. The synergies were implemented in engineering, dispatch, the usage of aircraft, which can all lead to cost benefits and competitive advantages. But what is special about Condor? What is the Condor spirit? This is the way how employees handle problems. Overall, there is a great cohesion among all employees, which mostly can be observed when there are extraordinary circumstances or external shocks. This has a direct effect on production, and when you are able to observe the speed and commitment with which the employees work on these problems, then I am always excited that this actually works. The Condor spirit is the big identification within the company. The Condor spirit means that all employees share the same goal, to bring our customers, the passengers, safely and comfortably to their destination.
Dass diese Airline es wirklich geschafft hat, den Pioniergeist und die familiäre Atmosphäre der wirklich.
It's clear that the airline managed to maintain its early pioneering spirit and friendly atmosphere during really difficult and exciting first years over the decades. 60 years have passed since Condor first flew to the Holy Land. And the small charter airline from back then now is one of the best-loved leisure airlines, with around 4,000 employees, 45 aircraft, and approximately 75 destinations worldwide. Since the maiden flight in 1956, Condor has flown more than 214 million passengers to their holidays in 60 years. Many challenges were mastered. After over 60 years, the most liked airline in Germany still feels the desire to fly. Happy birthday, dear Condor, and all the best for the future.
Happy birthday, Condor.
Happy birthday, Condor. Du schaffst das.
Happy birthday, Condor.
Happy birthday, Condor.
Condor, happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Condor.
Happy birthday, liebe Condor.
Happy birthday, Condor, my great love.
Happy birthday, Condor.